Hello everybody, Rossco here, and welcome to another Munro bagging episode, or photography bagging episode, or whatever the hell you want to call it. There's going to be photography, let me tell you. Anyway, back in Glencoe. Sorry about the white balance, I don't know why it keeps doing that. If I do that, there we go, that's better, you need to touch it. Anyway, so we're in Glencoe. So last time we were here, let me just see if I can get this thing working. We've done Buachaille Etive Beag, which is off to my left, your right. I'm really struggling to use this damn thing. I'm going to tell you, see if anybody's ever thinking about doing YouTube and they want to blog their travels, then you get these stupid DJI things, man. These are worthless for trails like this. But I'm bearing with it. Because I'm going to get rid of the damn thing, and I just want to make sure this is the reason why I'm getting rid of it. So yeah, I'm joined with Craig. He's just behind me, just there. Hey, Craig.
Hello.
And today we're going to be doing Buachaille Etive Beag.
Yes.
So where we were standing on the at the top of Buachaille Etive Beag, looking down into the valley, we're going to be doing the two mountains that are just across the valley from it. Which sound to that? I want you looking at my chins. More chins than a Chinese phone book. So yeah, looking forward to going to try out a new bag. So basically, I'm also going to be doing a review on this new bag that I have here. I'll show you that when I get stopped up. Actually, when I take five, bring that camera. There we go. Because the last one I found, it was. It's so sore. I mean, for the travelling that we're doing, I needed something that I wasn't ditching equipment with, and that I could just get everything I needed, get my camera in there. Everything was just there, so we're checking this out. And all the reviews that I've seen on this thing, they're all like, oh, come on, let's get the bag pack on and just go out there, and this is what I'm taking. It's like, that's no good for those that are walking in the wild lands of Scotland. So I'm doing it from a practical sense of view. I've got all the kit that I need in there that is relevant to what I'm doing here. So that sky's beautiful when you can see it. So yeah, I'll tell you how I'm feeling over the course of the walk here. So I'm going to put this thing away. I'm going to crack on. We'll get a wee view of what I'm seeing right now. Looking pretty spectacular behind me. I'll get that there. But I'll see you on the next one. By the way, I'm breathing Mars because we're going uphill straight away. See you in a minute. Maybe about an hour in, and it feels like we haven't done that much, but we're gaining some height. And to be honest, this path, as much as it's good, it's a slog up here. Cut back to the GoPro. I'm not messing around with that stupid Osmo thing. It is a pain in the butt. It's not even an Osmo. DJI Mobile 3 or whatever the hell it is. It's a pain in the absolute butt. had the drone out. Got some drone shots of this beautiful scenery. Stunning. Love the way the clouds are kind of forming. But not much to talk about now. Just going to keep battering on. Try and make up a bit of time for messing around with the GoPro. And yeah. I'll see you in a minute. So we're about 650, gone on 700 metres up. How's it been, Craig?
It's been tough. It's been kind of straight up. My skin is leaking.
Yeah, my skin's leaking too. I don't know, normally suffering leaking skin. But wait till you see this, guys. Honestly, this is... Honestly, how beautiful is that, mate, eh?
Incredible.
Is that good that Craig's getting his camera out? Ross, on the other hand.
The guy that's meant to be doing the photography
just cannot be bothered getting that camera out there. It's just there. I'll wait till I get a wee bit higher. I want to try and get that peak. Follow this ridge along this way, and then you can reach another Munro just down at it's near the Pap of Glencoe. So the Pap of Glencoe is the top of Glencoe, really. I think that's what it means. It's over that way. But for me and Craig, when we done what the hell was the name of that Meow Drag, that's that one right there poking out the top. Yeah, that's it there, mate. That's Meow Drag.
It's amazing, because you can see one there.
Yeah.
You can see one there. And yeah. One just over there.
It's honestly, guys, it is phenomenal. I don't even think the GoPro does any justice. But I'm thankful I'm recording this in 4K, 60 frames per second. So it's going to look mint. The midge's bothering you, mate.
Midges.
Yeah, we'll get moving in a second. Over there, if anybody's ever been to Glencoe or anything like that, for reference, that there, just over this side, is the left-hand back side of the Hidden Valley. But yeah, you can see all those cars and all this that parked down there. See, if you're standing down there, you would be able to see into the Hidden Valley of this, and then that allows you to get up to, I forget the name of the ridge over there. I used to think the Anakigak Ridge was on this side, but it's actually that side. And that would allow you to get up and then up the back buttress of the Hidden Valley and then crack on and do a few more Munros. You can actually see that cloud wisping its way down. It'd be nice if it was rolling, eh?
Yeah.
But hopefully that should clear out the midges a wee bit, eh? So how long have I been talking for? See, there's 2 minutes, right? I watched this guy and he was saying that, yo guys, make sure you keep your, if you're doing vlogs and all this that kind of stuff for travel, make sure you keep them down to 3 minutes and highly edit them. And I'm like, what are you? Yeah, that's all very well if you're like SoCal and fucking on the beaches of Daytona and all this, that's not going to work. But yeah, looking good. Cutting one. Cue epic B-roll. Wait a minute,
mate.
What for, mate?
To get a picture.
Oh, what are you thinking, a picture, mate? Are you going to take a picture of the fucking mighty Buachaille?
Of the mighty Buachaille.
That's what we done on Saturday, guys, all that ridge there. Do you see it booking? And then there's a Munro we're doing, which is called, what's it called again? It's got a name, I'll find out in a second. But there's a buttress. Just look at this, man. We're up in the clouds, man. This is crazy. Still not got the camera. It'll come out in a minute. Actually, do you want to know one of the reasons why I've punted it into the bag is because I couldn't get it. This here, this peak design, was up here. This camera's sticking in my face. It's annoying. So, but Craig told me you can move this strap further down, so I've put it there, so that makes all the difference. Look at this, guys, honestly. Look at this! Top of the world, dude. Oh my god, I'm getting the camera. I've got to. So there we go. I'm going to get a camera. Look at that. Honestly, stunning. What a day for it, mate, eh?
Yep.
I need a pee. You don't want to see that. Let's just... I know, and that's what adds to the time it takes us to get back home. Did we get the name of this? Oh. Craig's just going to check the name of this one. We're on Buachaille Etive Beag, or Beag, whatever way you want to put it, but we'll just get the name of the point. You see the clouds are lifted, we're right above it now. Yeah, but we've got maps, we've got GPSs. Where the hell is it? Oh. It's there, thank you. Stob Dubh. Dub. I think that's how you say it. But yeah. Oh, exposure on this is looking pretty crap, but I'll fix that post-production. When we were coming back down from Buachaille Etive Moor, you can actually, hang on, I'm going to sort this right out. It's overexposed, there we go. You can see that there's a like a trail kind of there, that's actually a waterfall we had to climb down. So that's like the middle section, so you've got the first point you do, and then you've got the one that's not a Munro, which is fucking ludicrous when you see it from here. And then you go down into the below the cloud level, back up along here, up to this one, which is another Munro, and then you go back down and you come back down this way and then walk out the valley. But when we were standing across here, maybe halfway along, probably about here, we were looking out across here and we seen people over. We were actually waving at them, it was crazy. That is it. I'm going to take that as a keyframe, mate. That's a fucking epic picture. So, while I'm sitting up the top here, I'm doing a time lapse of Glen Etive, which is just down there. Obviously, the clouds are kind of rolling in. I wanted to get a time lapse of it using the camera. So I'm currently using on this camera, I've got my stand, it's a K&F, it's kind of lightweight aluminium stand thing. It's not like some of these dudes with a peak design, can't afford that, so that's the next best thing. So I'm using that along with my Canon 6D and a 17-40mm lens, and I have the Peter McKinnon edition ND filter on the front, and I've currently set that to 3 stops. And then I'm using this little newfangled thing in order to get the time lapse, which is a Peak Design, Alpine Labs, I forget what they're called, it's basically a remote trigger. So I'm using that at the top. If I'm looking at, let me just see if it is actually doing its thing, or if it's stopped. So that's us just finished up there at the summit, absolutely clear. Got a load of good pictures, man, I can't wait to show you some. They should be pretty sweet. And yeah, just, I don't know, I just feel a wee bit, a little bit more invigorated. I've had a little snack to eat. I'm not hangry anymore. So yeah, now we're just walking along. Met a few people there, they said that from where we came up, which is called a Beelach, it's only about another 40 minutes to hit the other one. So that's 2 hours, almost 2 hours to go from there to the next one back down again. And then another hour, which is another hour and a half to get back down, probably a bit quicker than that. Back at the car for about 3-ish then. If that. I don't know. We'll make that up as we go along. But yeah, really happy with it. That Peter McKinnon thing, the ND filter, just looks absolutely amazing, doesn't it? It looks good through that, nice and clear. It doesn't improve the picture, but it just, I don't know, it'll take the glare off. So yeah, I'm going to be really looking forward to seeing how those turn out. But so far, now, as we walk along, it's been a good day so far. Tough at the start, not gonna lie that. Huh?
Tough at the start.
Look at that now, mate. How nice is that? How the hell is that not Munro? If there's anybody that's in the Munro Surveying Service or whatever the hell they are, get a grip, mate.
Get back up here.
And measure it. Yeah. Because that was mental.
That's not.
Yeah. That is. This one here is not a Munro. The one over there just in the clouds is. That's not. That one's not. This one is. Ludicrous.
Mental.
Mental. Checking Oriental. Is that the Blackwater Reservoir over there too? You can see that.
Yeah.
And there's the next Munro.
The next,
yeah, you can just see that little mound here. That's the next Munro. We're going to be walking along the ridge up to that one. Probably getting a little bit of sweat on again. But yeah, still pretty sweet, still pretty good. And we'll probably get lunch on the way back down from this one. Okay, so I'll close this off now. I'll see you when I pick it back up. Peace! That's us up the top of the smaller Munros, but no less of a grander view. So you can see into this valley where obviously the Buachaille Etive Beag, absolutely clear. It's super clear. This is, it's phenomenal. You kind of find yourself sitting, well, I found myself sitting back there just saying, man, this is amazing. And it's good to just finally get clear skies. So what I'm doing is I'm just heading to the edge. Craig's back there beside those people. That's where the wee cairn is, just back there. But I'm just going over here, stand up there, and then we'll spot some of the points out that we can see, and then obviously show you the view. And then once I've done that, I'll probably go back over, meet up with Craig, and then head on down. I think it's like 12 o'clock just now, so maybe take us a couple of hours to get back down. And then obviously I'll close the video when I get down to the bottom. But it's been good. This climb here has been pretty epic. I'm really happy with that. But let me just stand up here, and then I'll show you everything that's kind of going on. So let me get the screen up so I can see what's going on. Right, so that water way up there, just to my north, is that is Blackwater Reservoir, big massive dam at the end of it. Coming right down there, you'll see the car park where we parked before, to then climb up to go up the legendary Buachaille Etive Beag. And you can see the kind of ridge that we kind of traversed along there, kind of goes along. What else? I don't know what the name of that glen is down there, but it's pretty nice. 882 down there, pretty busy. And you can also see just down there, we say it is, for all intents and purposes, or was, Jimmy Savile's house. It's a shame what people are doing to it. It's such a beautiful location. You're probably better off just knocking that down and getting rid of it and building something new there. Just to get, people drive by it and it kind of stands for something, or a reminder. Nobody wants reminder of what that man did, so yeah. Dirty bastard, basically. But yeah, absolutely amazing. You can see for miles. I don't know what that mountain is away up the back there, but I think it might be Ben Lawyer's. I can't actually say for certain. Well, it could be anything, to be honest. But yeah, phenomenal. A big lock over there. I'm super happy. I'm really, really happy with this. So I'm going to take some more pictures with the old 6D, and I will need to text my missus. Text missus, tell him I actually get up here, do the 2OK, and then we'll be heading down shortly. But yeah, amazing. Love it. And you can actually see the Raineach Ridge just over there, I believe. Is it that one? I think that's it over there. Meal Drag over there as well. The one that we done in the snow. Go back, you can see that on the channel. But yeah, get back down to the car, get the drone out, get the drone coming down this valley with the waters running through. That should be pretty cool. Do that, and then I'm aiming to fly up the Buachaille. Yeah, stunning. I hope you think it is too. Loch Etive over there as well, just amazing. Craig coming for a visit. Ben Lawyer's over there, no Ben Lawyer's. Ben Stirav, you can see it with all the rocks kind of coming down from it. Epic. Epic.
Love it.
Getting down, almost at the car, maybe just another couple hundred metres, we'll be there. A lot of people coming up, still a lot of people coming down as well, so everybody's fairly loving it today. Sun's out, it's a phenomenal day. But in terms of toughness, I wouldn't say it was necessarily that tough. That was an adventure, it was pretty good. The hardest part is obviously the going up and then the coming back down. It's sore on the knees because you're at a weird angle, but anyway, just thinking back on it, I've really enjoyed myself today. I've found it, it's been really good. It's been amazing, got loads of great pictures. Man, I can't wait to show you, honestly. Some of these are going to be mint. So yeah, we're going to get down to the car, quick change, get the old drone out. I've got 3 battery packs for that. I'm going to fly them up that ravine there, up one, back down, back up the other one, back down. That's one battery pack. I don't know what I'm doing with the other one, but for the big battery, I'm flying it up the Buachaille. It's happening today, so I'm really excited about that. But yeah, if you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Go on and check the Facebook page for Rossco.Munro photography. I'm also on Instagram. If you're interested in first person view drones, you can have a look at Rossco FPV. I've got all my flights and all this, these things I've just kind of talked about there on there now. And yeah, so for me and Craig, we will say goodbye and we'll see you all later. Thanks for watching, guys.
Bye.
Oh yeah,
I keep forgetting to do the palm.